Welcome to another webinar session of CA Sri Lanka webinar series. Today I am going to discuss with you another very important topic, which is preparation of financial statement for companies. So if you go back to our previous webinar series, which means somewhere in 2020 or 2021 beginning, we have done a session for preparation of financial statement of proprietor companies. Tani pujjal vyapara, we have done it. So this session is to cover the preparation of financial statement for companies. There are little difference between preparation of financial statement of proprietors and when you prepare financial statement for a company. Concept is same, whether it's proprietor company or a private limited company. You can't deviate from the fundamentals, but the double entry rule, debit credit. So you can't deviate from that. If asset debit, whether it's company accounts or proprietor account, asset will be debit. But the format, the presentation, all these things little different. So those differences you can identify today. For you to identify those differences, you must have good understanding about what the preparation of financial statement for what companies, proprietor companies. Fine. So that's what we are going to discuss here. At the end of this session, we will complete not comprehensive, basic question which covers preparation of financial statements, including statement of comprehensive income, statement of financial position, and statement of changes in equity. So those component we will prepare with that question. It has few adjustments. So those who are not good for company accounts, those are not good in company preparation of company accounts, this session will help you to understand the way you prepare financial statement from trial balance. Normally examiner will give you trial balance with some adjustments, finally examiner will ask you to calculate what profit. Since this is MCQ question, lengthy question will not be tested, but by giving profit, right, examiner will give you some notes, you have to adjust those notes to the profit and calculate revised profit, kind of questions can be tested. But for you to do that, you must have good understanding about what preparation of financial statements. Even though this is MCQ and examiner is not going to test lengthy questions, it is important to understand how do you prepare financial statement. Therefore, stay with me till end of this session, so then you will gain fair understanding about preparation of financial statement, including knowledge of what? LKS 1, right? Fine. LKS 1, preparation of financial statement for the company, that is the accounting standard. The standard objective, so number is not there, right? But the objective of the standard is what? How to present financial statements. How to present financial statements. So when we talk about presentation of financial statements, right, we need to understand definitions of the standard, that is number one. And what are the features of financial statements? There are a lot of features. When you prepare financial statement, you have to think about going concern assumption, you have to think about materiality, you have to think about accrual concept. Those are features. So what are the features of financial statements? And when you prepare financial statement, what is the structure? If you take P&L, what, profit and loss account, or else other statement of comprehensive income, what is the structure of that? And when you prepare balance sheet, what is the structure of that? We need to discuss. And content of financial statement. So once you finalize structure, what you will include there? Content a financial statement. So we need to finalize those things, we need to learn these things, then only you can say we have presented financial statement properly. That is the objective of this standard LKS 1. General features of financial statement, very important, right? General features, there are a lot of things you can see in this slide. Number 1, fair presentation and compliance. Fair presentation means what? Normally auditor also will tell at the end of his audit, financial statement are present fairly. Fair presentation features. Number 1, fair presentation. Fair presentation and compliance. When you prepare financial statement, you must comply with relevant accounting standard. You must comply with what? Relevant accounting standard. Compliance with SLFRS, LKS and other legal requirements. That is the compliance. Anukoola venawa kiyanne. Fair presentation means sadharana representation ekak thiyenawa. So fair presentation also will ensure through if you prepare financial statement according to what? LKS. So this SLFRS, LKS developed for us to achieve what? Fair presentation of financial statement. So you must comply with those things. That is why it says fair presentation and compliance. That is first feature when you prepare financial statements, a financial statement. Second one, going concern. Going concern. What do you mean by going concern? You will tell me ability to run the business for foreseeable future. Foreseeable future. Ability to run the business for foreseeable future, which means short term, at least for next 12 months. You should be able to run the business at least for next 12 months, which is called going concern. So management should assess before they present financial statement whether they have a going concern or not, right? If they have going concern, you have this classification in your balance sheet. What classification? Non-current and current classification. That's why you have non-current asset, non-current liabilities and current asset and current liabilities. If you don't have going concern, you don't have non-current classification, only you have what? Current classification. If you don't have going concern, if you can't run the business for next 12 months, no point of recognizing asset and liabilities which are which generate cash for the business after 12 months. Oh, more than 12 months, no, I can't say after 12 months, more than 12 months, obligation that you need to settle over more than 12 months. No point of recognizing that. Why? After another 12 months, you will not run the business because you don't have going concern. If you have going concern, only you can bring this classification, current and non-current classification, if not, no. Before you prepare financial statement, you have to come to that conclusion. Then accrual basis, number 3, accrual basis. Opposite side of this is what? Cash basis. Opposite side of this, right? This is opposite side. Opposite side. So LKS 1 says you have to prepare financial statement based on accrual basis, not based on what? Cash basis. Accrual basis means you have to deduct all expenses from the revenue that you have generated for the period, irrespective of whether you have paid or not. Let's say your March electricity, your accounting period end up with 31st March 2021. Let's say the last day of financial year. So March electricity bill you will receive in April, no? March electricity bill you will receive April. But if you don't deduct March electricity bill, right? March electricity bill from this financial year, and if you take it to April because you are receiving it April and cash outflow will be there in April, right? You will pay cash April because bill will come during the month of April. But you have to recognize that expense to the in the month of March. Why? Because electricity, utilities, you have incurred to generate March month sale and to produce goods or services or to deliver services during the month of March. Therefore, you will generate some income during March by producing goods or by delivering services. For you to do that, you have incurred some electricity during the month of March. Therefore, you had incurred that cost to the March. That's why it says you have to go by accrual basis, not the cash basis. Those are features, right? Fourth one. Important to understand these things, right? Materiality and aggregation. Materiality and aggregation, which means all material balances, all material transactions, you must consider for preparation of financial statements. And some of them are individually material, some of them are aggregately material. Immaterial things you will not consider, but material transaction you should use for preparation of financial statements. Number 5. Number 5 says offsetting. Asset and liability not allowed. Right, asset and liabilities you can't set off each other. You can't set off asset against liabilities unless it is permitted by the relevant accounting standard. Some accounting standard they allow. Right, we will discuss this concept in advance later on. But understand, normally LKS 1 is not allowing offsetting unless it is permitted by the relevant standard to do so. Right, if it is allowing under specific circumstances, you can do it. Okay, standard will again, right? You can do this in this situation, unless you can't do it offsetting. You can't do offsetting. Number 6, frequency of reporting. Frequency, right? Frequency of reporting. What is the frequency of reporting? Normally you prepare financial statement for 12 months. You have to prepare financial statement at least annually. Standard say annually you have to prepare financial statement, mandatory. So which means normally we prepare financial statement 1st April, right, whatever the year, till 31st March, whatever the year. So this is a 12 months period, annual financial statement prepared from this day to that day. But some companies like financial institutions, they prepare financial statement from 1st January of whatever the year till 31st December whatever the year. So those are the two financial periods. Frequency, don't worry about this date. The frequency is what? Annually, 12 months. Comparative information, very important. When you present financial statement, comparative, comparative information you must include. What do you mean by comparative information? Now let's say when you present, when you prepare a financial statement, you will present sales, right? Revenue. Let's say this is P&L, revenue. 2020 financial year. So when you present revenue 2021 figure, right, you have to present compared to last year sales under this revenue category. That also you have to present. So then you can see, you can compare with last year's financial year. Comparative information also you have to present. That's a requirement of LKS 1. What is next? Consistency. Again, very important. Consistency. Consistency means when you select and apply accounting policies, principles, you have to follow same accounting policy without changing year on year, which is called consistency. Good example I can give you, let's say you prepare financial statements, when you prepare financial statement, you depreciate assets by using what? Straight line method. This year, next year you decide, no, no, straight line method is not the best method, I need to select what? Reduce imbalance method. You change straight line to reduce imbalance. Then next year again you think, oh, no, reduce imbalance is not appropriate now, go to what? Straight line method. You change, there is no consistency, you can't apply like that. Once you select and apply accounting policy, it should be consistently applied for future years. Another good example I can give you. Now let's say today you decided all property, plant and equipment, all furniture and fittings category, I'm going to revalue. So revaluation is my method, policy, right? Next year, not revaluation method, I need to move into cost method, because standard is allowing, but standard says best method is what? Revaluation method. So once you select revaluation method, it is not good to go again back to what? Cost method, but you can, right? And next day again, revaluation, cost to revaluation, revaluation cost, likewise you change, right? You can't apply like that. When you apply accounting policy, it should be consistent for a longer period, for future years also. Otherwise, if you don't have consistency, you don't have, if it is not there, you don't have comparability. If you don't have consistency, no comparability. For if you want comparable, you need to compare information. Yes, consistency is mandatory, right? Because how do you compare depreciation if you last year depreciated based on straight line method and this year reducing balance method? You can't do it. Let's see, how do you compare property, plant and equipment if last year evaluation, this year cost? You can't do it. Therefore, accounting policy, when you select and apply, it should be consistent for future years. So these are the features of financial statements, right? So these factors you need to consider when you prepare and present financial statements, right? Fine, done. Complete set of financial statement. So what are the components including complete set of financial statements? Number one, financial position, financial performance and cash flow statement. There are three things. In complete set of financial statements, we need to present financial position. How do you present, how do you calculate, or how do you figure out financial position? For you to present or observe financial position, you need to prepare statement of financial position. In your language, it is balance sheet. But technically speaking, The correct name of that statement is what? Statement of financial position. Statement of financial position will ensure what? Your liquidity, investment versus funding, all these things, right? That is what is your financial position, right? Balance sheet. Then the organization performance reflect where? In statement of profit and loss and other comprehensive income. Statement of profit and loss and other comprehensive income. Earlier we call it as what? Normally, still now we are calling this as what? P&L. But the correct name is what? Statement of financial, statement of profit and loss and other comprehensive income, and statement of changes in equity. Shareholders lage watina account ekoy thiyenne statement of changes in equity. Equity means net asset. Net asset means shareholders funds, shareholders ownership, basically what? Share capital and retained earning. So that is also ensure what? Organization's performance. So performance measurement, for you to measure organization financial performance, you prepare what? Those two statements. And we talks about accrual basis, whether you paid or not, all income and expenses, all in expenses you will identify for the given period, then only the correct performance will be reflect. But the real cash position, you may end up with profit by considering accrual basis, may profit or loss, but whether you have cash or not, understanding that also real important, right? If you don't have cash, you can't run the business. Therefore, cash position also really important to understand. To understand cash position, right, what statement you need to prepare? Cash flow statement, which is called statement of cash flow, right? So there are four statements, four component: statement of financial position, statement of profit and loss and other comprehensive income, and statement of changes in equity, and statement of cash flow, and finally all disclosure requirements related to each of these. You will include where? Notes to the financial statements, notes. Those are the five component of financial statements. In addition to that, don't forget to include what? Comparatives. LKS 1 specifically says you must include what? Comparative information also. So I am going to I would like to give you a very important message here, because the examiner will ask component of financial statement, which means these five. Sometimes the examiner can test asking what? Elements of financial statements. Elements means income, expenses, asset, liabilities, equity, and notes. So those are the elements of financial statement. So elements are different from what? Component. Don't be confused between these two. But when I ask this question, what are the components? Student is answering elements. When I ask elements, they are talking about what? Component. Right? Don't mix those two things. Complete set of financial statements. Complete set of financial statement comprise, this is standard, these five statements we went through. And final paragraph, if you read, comparative information should be provided for all amounts. You have to provide comparative information for all amounts reported in the financial statements and in the notes. So comparative information you have to provide in the financial statement itself as well as to the note also. Comparative information is relevant amount for the previous period. Comparative information means previous period data, right? If you prepare financial statement for 2020, right, 2021, the comparative will be from 2020 financial year. Done. Statement of profit or loss. This is really important to understand, right? If I take you all through this slide first, right, paragraph 88 of LKS 1. So now you should be able to read accounting standard also, right? The relevant paragraph also there. Download and see whether this paragraph is there or not. The statement of profit or loss is the most significant indicator. I make some notes. Most significant indicator of company's financial performance. If someone asks whether you are performing better, have you performed better this year? Right? By looking at financial position, balance sheet, you can't tell that. You must prepare what? Profit and loss statement. Statement of profit or loss. So look at this. So there's a confusion, right? If you don't, this will create confusion if you don't clarify this properly. Let me clarify that first. This is there in the future slide, but we'll clarify this first and move into those slides. Financial performance. Financial performance reflect where? In statement of comprehensive income. Hurry to give one. Statement of comprehensive income. Right? This will reflect financial performance. Statement of financial performance has two things. Right? Statement of profit or loss, statement of profit or loss, right? Here, statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive, statement of other comprehensive income. Right? අපි මේ දෙකම එකතු කරලා කියනවා මොකද? Statement of comprehensive income. We call it as statement of comprehensive income. It has two things, statement of profit or loss or statement of comprehensive. There are two things. Right? Two statements. So, this reflect organization performance from normal course of business. Performance from normal course of business. Normal course of business. Day-to-day business activities. Basically, P&L can be made. Profit and loss. Right? අපි ආමත හැබැයි මේ දෙක එකතු කරලා මේ මේකට P&L කියලා කියනවා. වරද්ද ගන්න එපා. Examiner ඇහුවොත් statement of comprehensive income means these two equal to this. Statement of comprehensive income means statement of profit and loss plus statement of other comprehensive income. These two together we identify as statement of comprehensive income. Statement of profit and loss means part of this. That is what we are going to discuss here. Statement of profit or loss. Then make a backup go my slide deck. They are talking about this. No. They are talking about this part of this equation. Statement of profit or loss. Then balanne kiyala. The statement of profit or loss is the most significant indicator of financial performance. Yes, agreed. Because this reflect performance from normal course of business. So what is this? I will come to this later on. Right? This will not reflect day-to-day business transaction. All income and expenses will represent here, and this will give you profit for the period. Answer is what? Profit for the period. Profit for the period will be given by this statement. Right? Fine. So it is important to ensure that is not misleading. Therefore, this reflects performance of the financial year, profit for the year, therefore this should be accurate, which means no should not be misleading. The statement of profit or loss will misleading if cost incurred in the current year are deducted not from the current year profit but from the balance or accumulated profit brought forward. This present foreign years results more favorably. Ekena mehema kathandarayak. Right mehema hitanna. Your electricity bill 31st March 2021. So on this day your March electricity bill, water bill will not be available. And March bill you will receive from electricity board during April. If you don't deduct, expenses of this year will be what? Reduce. When you reduce expenses your performance will be overstated. That's why I say this present, the current financial year's result more favorably, which is called misleading. That's why it's required to use accrual basis when you prepare financial statements. Keep that also in your mind. LKS 1 stipulated that all items of income and expenses recognized in the period shall be included in the profit or loss unless standard or interpretation required otherwise. Now LKS 1 says you always should follow this accrual basis unless some other standard says no, follow some other basis. If not, all expenses and income should be recognized in your profit and loss accounts on what basis? Accrual basis. Example, circumstances of the item may be excluded from profit or loss for the current year includes correction of errors. Correction of errors you will adjust where sometimes you retain earning, or effect of changes in equity, accounting policy, accounting policy changes, correction of errors LKS 8, right? Those will not adjust in current financial year, right? Not the current period, but all other things you adjust for what? Current period. Statement of profit and loss continues. The statement of comprehensive income, statement of comprehensive income takes the statement of profit or loss. Statement of profit or loss adjust it for certain gain and losses that are included in equity but not shown on the profit, which means this, right? Then mithana kiyanne adjust, you will adjust this statement of profit and loss adjust to what? Reflect certain gain and losses that are included in the equity but not shown in the profit, which means gain from revaluation. Mithana api include karana mokadda? Gain from revaluation, right? These are not normal course of business. That's why for the profit for the period you add gain from revaluation, so then you will end up with what? This statement, right? Comprehensive income. LKS 1 allow the company to choose the presentation, right? One statement, you can choose either one statement, which is called statement of comprehensive income, right? Statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive, both together, right? These two you can present as one statement, right? As one statement. Ena api nama danna kohomada? Statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income. Balanna kiyala, statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income as one set of financial statement, one statement, or else two separate statement. Emanoth komad danni statement of profit or loss and statement of other comprehensive income. Me deka separate statement vidiyata present karannat puluwa, dekama ekathu karala as one statement vidiyata present karannat puluwa. LKS 1 allows. Therunani statement එකට දානවනම් කොහමද නම දාන්නේ statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income එහෙම නැත්නම් මේ කියන්නේ statement of comprehensive income එහෙම කියන්නත් පුළුවන් as when you present as one statement එහෙම නැත්නම් ඔයාලට පුළුවන් statement of profit or loss one separate statement and statement of other comprehensive income separate statement එහෙම දාන්නත් පුළුවන් LKS 1 para 10 a explain that properly right okay The standard allows entities to use title of the financial statement other than those in the standard example can use title standard of statement of comprehensive income title එක මං කිව්වේ statement of comprehensive income මේ දෙකම එකට දානවා statement of comprehensive income කියලා දාන්න පුළුවන් right instead statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income which means Either you can say statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income. එහෙම කියන්නත් පුළුවන් නම. එක දිගට. Statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income. Or else you can say statement of comprehensive income. දෙකම එකයි. Right? මම ඔයාලට මෙහෙම කියන්නම් පොඩක් තේරෙන විදියට. These are little things but important. නම කොහොමද දාන්නේ you can say statement of profit or loss and right other comprehensive statement Other comprehensive income, sorry. Other comprehensive income. Right? When you present as one, present as one statement. Or else you can say at the same time, statement of comprehensive income dekhne ka hai two separate statement present as two statement statement of profit or loss And profit or loss statement. Profit or loss statement of profit or loss. May I give you a statement of right statement of profit or loss and statement of other comprehensive. When you present as two statements, right? Make a sarlam katandre. So this is how do you include title when you prepare financial statements, other comprehensive income statement, right? Fine. Okay, done. Identification of financial statements. When you identify financial statements, this is also important. Normally, appeared on P&L balance sheet. මේ ලෙවල් එකේ ඔයාලා ෆිනෑන්ෂියල් ස්ටේට්මන්ට් ලියලා හදන්න කියන්නේ නෑනේ. ඒ හින්දා ඔයාලා ලියන විදිය හරිද කියලා බලන්න බෑ එක්සැමිනර්ට. බට එක්සැමිනර් කෙන් ඩිරෙක්ට්ලි ආස්ක්. What are the factors that you need to consider when you identify financial statement? What are the things you must definitely include? Right when you identify financial statements. So these things must be there. What? Name of the reporting entity. Right? ABC Limited. Whether accounts cover single entity or group of entity, whether you are preparing consolidated financial statement or individual entity's financial statement, that classification should be there. And reporting date, as at which date you prepare financial statement, or for the year ended, what date you have to ensure that also. and reporting currency. Normally we don't include sometimes, no? අපි ලියන්න අපි දන්නවා LKR තමයි ලංකාවේ ඔක්කොම LKR වලින් දාලා හදනවා කියලා. No, you have to mention reporting currency. Even though you prepare in LKR, you and myself, we know this company's accounts are in LKR, but you must mention that, right? Because different users will use these financial statements. The level of precision, which means අපි have thousands, දහස් වලින් දානවා කියන අන්න එක. Used in presenting figures in the financial statement. Those things mandatory. Look at this. CPD box group. That's what? Name of the entity, reporting entity. Right? Statement of comprehensive income. Right? Statement of comprehensive income. Statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income both together. Right? Which is the title. Right? And for the year ended. For the year ended, reporting date, right, ended 31st December 2021, or whatever the year, reporting currency, euro, right, in thousands. So, all these elements must be there. So, this is how do you present, this is how do you write title of the financial statement, right, which, to identify what it is and for what year. Which company, which date, in which currency, whether it's thousand or not, all these things must be mentioned. And you can see comparatives also there. Statement of financial position. Statement of financial position means balance sheet in your language. So balance sheet has three elements. No, basically in comprehensive income you include what? Income and expenses. In balance sheet, statement of financial position, you will include what? Assets, liabilities and equity. Assets, liabilities and equity. You will include asset, liabilities and equity. Right? So, under asset, what do you have? Property, plant and equipment, investment property, intangible assets such as goodwill and investment by equity method. Right? Which means investment in associate company, which is not there in your syllabus. We will discuss this thing later on. Financial assets, IFRS 9, right? Financial instrument, if there is. Biological assets, if you have livestock, biological asset, plants, right? Livestock. Inventories, current asset, right? Trade and other receivable, which means debtors, cash and cash equivalent. So, these are the balances that you can see asset side in the balance sheet, right? And liability and equity side, you have trade and other payables, provisions, financial liabilities coming from financial instrument standard, which is not there in your syllabus, don't worry. Non-controlling interest within equity, again, this is not there in your syllabus. Consolidated financial statement when you prepare, right? Non-controlling interest also will be there, don't worry. You will learn these things later on, and next level maybe, not maybe, definitely. Issued capital and reserves, capital and reserves, share capital, right? So, those are things you will mention, you will include where under asset and liabilities. So, some transaction can be there in asset side, sometimes may be in liability side, right? අපිට කියන්න බෑ එක බලපුවම මේක asset ද liability ද කියලා, right? Number 1, asset and liabilities come under IFRS 5, forget about it, that is not there in your syllabus, but I'll take what is there in your syllabus. Group of contract, asset and liabilities, that is also forget about for the time period IFRS 17, right? Leasing, IFRS 17. එකක් පොඩ අතාරින්න දැනට. මේක බලන්න. Current tax and liabilities, income tax, we don't know whether you have deferred tax asset, deferred tax liabilities. Current tax එකත් අපි දන්නේ නැහැ liability ද asset එකක්ද කියලා. So, deferred tax, you may have asset or liability. It can be there in asset side or liability side. Last example will give you good insight to understand some elements, some account balances. Straight away, today I can't say deferred tax, asset or liability. Depends, right? So, if it is asset, in asset side, if it is liability, liability side. So those transaction, those kind of transaction also they are in the financial position, right? Fine. In addition to that, what you need to understand, I told you at the very beginning, right? All assets and liabilities you can divide into two classification, which is current and non-current. Current means assets which are available in the business to recover within next 12 period. Liabilities means those are obligations, those obligations you have to fulfill within next 12 months, right? Other than all these current and current asset and current liabilities, the rest of them will be what? Non-current asset and non-current liability. අපි ඊළඟ අවුරුදු ඊළඟ මාස 12 ඇතුළත recover කරගන්නේ current assets, inventory, ඊළඟ මාස 12 විකුණනවා. Cash anyway current asset. Trade receivable what within less than 12 months you period you have to recover. Right? Current liabilities within 12 months you have to settle OD. They are not allowing you to pay in 1.5 years or 2 years time. Trade payables you have to settle within another 12 months. Right? So therefore, current asset and current liabilities, which means within 12 months, beyond 12 months if there is any, those are non-current asset and non-current liabilities. That classification is there in the balance sheet based on going concern. Right? Done. Next one. The asset should be classified as current when? When do you classify asset as current assets? It is expected to be resulted in or held for sale or consumption inventory, example, right? Expected to be realized, trade debtors, example. The entity's normal operating cycle, a normal operating cycle, like you are expecting to realize or consume, right? In normal entity's operating cycle, is held for, is held primarily for the purpose of being traded. A whole current innum vikunanda, trading purpose, current assets. Is expected to be realized within 12 months period after the reporting date. If your reporting date is 31st March, this is your reporting period, 31st March 2021. Your reporting period end up with this date, within next 12 months. Which means prior to 31st March 2021, you are going to recover those assets. Then you will identify it as what? Current assets. These are very simple things, you know. Is cash or cash equivalent, which is not restricted in its use. You can use at any given point cash or cash equivalent. If there is a restriction of using those as you wish at any given point, that will not come under current asset. But normally a cash and cash equivalent you can use within 12 months. If not, let's say you have a fixed deposit, you can't withdraw it is for next 12 months. So then definitely it is what? Non-current asset. That's how you classified all other assets are what? Non-current assets. Opposite side of it, current liabilities, simple, same. Not same, but simple to understand. A liability should be classified as current when is expected to be settled. You are expecting to settle in a asset taken or realize current. Make a settle current. Right? In the end, it is normal operating cycle. Normal operating cycle, you are expecting to settle those. Is due to be settled within 12 months of the period date. You are expecting to settled. Right, within 12 months period from the end of the reporting period, right, is held primarily for the purpose of being traded. Trading purpose tama oya tiyagena inne monoda current liabilities. Is that it does not mean it does not have to have a rights at the reporting date to defer settlement of a liability by transferring cash or other cash for latest 12 months after reporting period. That definition explain what? Assets held, liabilities primarily held for the purpose of being traded. Ekenne eke theruma thama me kiyala thiyen, right? But don't go into that level, but understand if you are keeping something for trading purpose, that's also come under liabilities. All other liabilities will be classified as what? Non-current liabilities. Simple. You know these things, right? Fine. Balanna mata meka kiyala. There are also current liabilities which are not settled. There are current liabilities which are not settled as a part of normal operating cycle. Current liabilities thiyenalu, but which are not settled as a part of normal operating cycle, but which are due to be settled within 12 months reporting period, 12 months of the reporting period. These include bank overdraft, income tax, non-trade payables, and current portion of interest-bearing borrowings, any interest-bearing liabilities, right? Any interest-bearing liabilities that are used to be financed working capital, long-term basis, working capital, long-term basis, and that are not due for settlement within 12 months should be classified as non-current liabilities. ekoda explain karanna mehema. Ada anna deval. But important to understand again, right? See this. You have a loan, bank loan. You have taken it from working capital. Working capital means what? Your working capital cycle. You have a cash. Cash will use to purchase, which means payable will generate. Then it will become inventory. Inventory vikunu paamu kada venni? Receivable hadena. Right? Receivable are cash, you know. Minna operating cycle leka. Working capital cycle. Meken working capital cycle again. සල්ලි දින බඩු ගන්නවා පේබල් හැදෙනවා සර් මේ අපි එහෙම දෙමු බඩු ඉන්වෙන්ටරි විකුණනවා ණයට ඒතර රිසීවබල් හම්බෙනවා රිසීවබල් එකක් වෙනවා ඩෙටර්ස් ඩෙටර්ස් ලාගෙන් සල්ලි හම්බෙනවා රයිට් සල්ලි හම්බෙනවා then you purchase on credit basis then payable වෙනවා payable කරපුවම ඉන්වෙන්ටරි වලට එකතු වෙනවා නේ payable inventory මේක තමයි working capital cycle to purchase goods to invest in inventories invest in working capital you have taken a bank loan. So, part of this will settle after 12 months. So, this should be identified as what? Non-current liabilities, basically. That's what it is, right? Any interest-bearing liabilities that are used to finance working capital on long-term basis that are not due for the settlement within 12 months should be classified as non-current liabilities. But 12 months period ekka current liabilities lo danawa within 12 months. Within 12 months settle karanawa current liabilities lo danawa. That's all. Right? Oka thama kathandaya. Current liabilities. Statement of changes in equity. Statement of changes in equity. Equity statement. Total comprehensive income. Dapi katakaran financial position katakara, comprehensive income statement katakara. Then mukata katakaran din. Third one. Statement of changes in equity. Ekatri dinolu. Total comprehensive income. Total comprehensive income you will take it to changes in equity, not to the balance sheet directly, then effect of retrospective application or restatements. If you are doing some adjustments which are effect to previous years, right? Previous years, material errors, if you correct, you will correct those to adjust those to what? Retained earning. Api here retained earning has an all. Retrospective adjustments means you have identified something today, 2021. But the impact of this should be adjusted to previous year's financial year. Let's say 2020 financial year.
But 2020 financial year, financial statement already prepared and performance reflecting where? Retained earning. You adjust retained earning. Hari ni? Methana hadannoni habe balapama innoni me avurudda financial statement hadali iwarai eka performance thiyena retained earning wala me koye thiyenne changes in equity wala right e adjustment ek karanna hena changes in equity thiyenne koda retained earning menna methanne karana adjustment api kiyana retrospective adjustments ewa reflect enne koda changes in equity and movement of each component of equity share capital movements retained earning movements will be there in changes in equity statement right fine sorry yeah then notes last one gain sorry general information plus compliance with IFRS accounting policies source of elimination uncertainty capital putable instrument forget about it you it is out of your syllabus dividends all these things will be included where under notes general informations let's say cost of sale breakup administrative expense breakup you will include where under notes as general information accounting policies you will disclose where under notes source of estimation uncertainty estimates you will include where under notes capital breakup it's not property plant and equipment depreciation cost of sorry cost nrv sorry current carrying amount all this pp not under notes simple so this is the format of statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income මේ තියෙන formats ටික බලන්න formats කොහොමද තියෙන එක LKS 1 specifies what should be included in the statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income and includes a suggested format they have included the suggested format also some item must be disclosed in the face of the balance statement some items you must include you must present where in the face of the statement බලන්න කොහොමද තියෙන්නේ කියලා ABC company statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income for the year ended 31st December 2020 whatever the year illustrating classification of expenses by function බලන්න revenue තියෙනවා cost of sale gross profit other income distribution expenses administrative expenses other expenses finance cost before profit before tax then you have adjust tax profit for the year till that point profit for the year we identify as what statement of profit and loss statement of profit and loss balanna meke deka thiyenawane statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income kiyala and statement of profit and loss will be ended up with what profit for the year when you add other comprehensive income such as gain from revaluation when you revalue asset there's a gain So that gain you will add to what profit for the year. Then you can take what total comprehensive income for the year. Total comprehensive income reflect what both profit profit or loss and other comprehensive income together we identify as what comprehensive income. This is the format. Important. Make what important. What the question in the exam may refer to the statement. Statement of profit or loss. This means entries from revenue to profit for the year. Mena balanna. Revenue to profit for the year reflect what? Statement of profit or loss. Revenue ekem patangana profit for the year wenakal statement of profit or loss. Hondata mata thiyaganna. Man meka thama ochchala kiyage hitiya. Examine අහන්නේ මොකක්ද කියන එක තේරුම් ගන්න ඉස්සලා reference to other comprehensive income meaning last 3 lines මොනවද profit for the year එකට add කරන other comprehensive income in your syllabus only one they are talking about gain from revaluation then you will end up with total comprehensive income හොඳට බලන්න එක්සැමින අහන්නේ profit for the year එක්සැමින අහන්නේ statement of profit and loss ද එහෙනම් ඔයා නතර කරන්න ඕනි profit for the year එකෙන් එක්සැමින අහුවොත් statement of comprehensive income which is combination of profit for the year plus other comprehensive income right දැන් වාදි ගන්න මොකක්ද අහන්නේ කියලා හොඳට තේරුම් ගන්න however reference to the statement of comprehensive income means what or statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income means all statement right statement of comprehensive income ku deke me ekathu mokadda deka tiyenne statement of profit and loss and statement of other comprehensive income deke me ekathuwa oka tama mulidi kiwwe methin methara me methara hondara eka therum kala dilame statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income there are two things profit or loss and other comprehensive income profit or loss means revenue finance cost share of profit eka matak karanna oya dannae eka tax expense total discontinued operation eka oya dannit ne right fine other comprehensive income means each component of OCI eke me ekakwatta oya dannae habe meten other comprehensive income kiyala oyage syllabus ekata thiyena thiyenne mokadda gain from revaluation gain or loss from revaluation kammanda wat other comprehensive income හොඳට බලන්න අවසානට profit or loss plus total other comprehensive income equal to what comprehensive income that's why you can name your financial statement as statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income or statement of comprehensive income right same face of the statement of profit or loss face එක statement of profit and loss එක is face එක මොකද්ද revenue finance cost share of profit and loss of joint venture එක අදන්න tax තියෙනවා අදන්න single amount of total discontinued operation එයා පැතිපු slide එකම තමයි right notes this is this item related to group accounting which are covered later in this text note that joint ventures are not included in this syllabus joint ventures වගේ නෑ discontinued operation not in this syllabus for this syllabus only other comprehensive income are gain on revaluation of property plant and equipment ehenam me syllabus eke other comprehensive income kiyala tiyenne gain from revaluation reserve pamanai gain from revaluation of property plant and equipment pamanai thawa thiyenawa ඒවා ඉස්සරහට ඉගෙන ගයි. එන්නවා දැන් ඉගෙන ගන්න ඕනේ. අපි ඉස්සරහට ඉගෙන ගමු. මේ සිලබස් එක ඇතුලේ තියෙන්නේ only gain from revaluation of property plant and equipment under other comprehensive income. Done. Salaries. එකපාරම කොහොමද මේ salaries කියන topic එකට ආවේ? This is also really important. Exam can be tested. That's why I included, right? The salary of sole proprietor or partner in a partnership, right, is not a charge to statement of profit or loss, but it is an appropriation of profit. Partnership ekaka hari proprietor company ekaka hari salaries for partners or proprietor. Will not be charged to PNL. Why? Owners are not separate from the entity. At the time of liquidation, the liabilities will extend to owners' private properties also if it is a proprietor of the partnership. Pigana gatanne lakshana characteristic. That's why salaries paid to them. You will not identify it as what reduction of profit as expense, but it will charge to appropriation account or if it is proprietor capital account. The statement the salaries of employees of the private limited company, right, right, including directors' fee, however, are expenses in the statement of profit or loss. Including under administrative expenses, sometimes maybe distribution expenses depends on the nature of the salary. this difference is because, aimee difference again, because strictly speaking, the term salary refers to payment made to employees, payment made to staff, payment made to their staff. A sole proprietor cannot employ themselves, and therefore, term salary, sole proprietor is not technically a salary, but is an extraction or appropriation of profit. However, it is common for term salary, so drawing to be included, drawings to be used to describe extraction of profit by sole proprietor. Man kiyunada tani pujjala vyaparayaka salary gewana nan aithikaruta eka salary yak neve why vyaparaya saha vyaparikaya dedenek nove ekkene at the liquidation the liability will extend to their private properties also. Therefore, private limited companies will salaries paid to management will identify as or include in director fee as expense, whereas private limited, sorry, proprietor and partnership, you will not charge it to PNL. Hondara madhi jagan can be tested. Meka handa puluwa. Taxation, simple. The company, that's example, simple example, we'll work out this example so then you will understand. Right, read this question. A company has tax liability brought forward of rupees 15 million. The liability is finally agreed at rupees 17.5 million and this is paid during the year. The company estimate that the tax liability based on the current year's profit will be 20 million. Prepare tax liability for the year. You have to prepare tax liability for the year. You can prepare small T account, tax, right? Brought forward tax figure how much? Brought forward tax liability 15. Brought forward, will work out in thousands, 15 million, right? The liability finally agreed to 17.5 million, carried forward, sorry, liability agreed finally, final tax liability for the year, tax liability is 17,500. Tax katakara, right? LKS 12 standard varanagila. The company estimate the tax liability based on current financial profit will be 20. The company's estimated tax liability based on the current year's profit. How much? 20. At the end of the day, you have current tax liability, right? Carried forward current 20,000, right? Prepare tax liability account. Clear tax liability account. 0057 37,500. Right? For PNL. This amount you charge to PNL, how much? $22,500. This is the amount you charge to PNL. That's what they are asking, no? Prepare tax liability for the year. Simple. Gain or loss from revaluation. Gain or loss from revaluation. Right? I told you this is the only one element which is applicable under this level. Right? Under this level, which means BL1. When you prepare other comprehensive income statement, there are some more elements like actuarial gain from gratuity, all these things will be there, but for your level, don't go into that extent, stay with gain from revaluation. That's the only element that examiner will test under this level. This arises when a property is revalued. When you revalue a property, this will arise. The revaluation is usually recognized in other comprehensive income. Revaluation is normally usually recognized in other comprehensive income part of the statement of profit. Other comprehensive income ulama recognize karaganne etta income part of the statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income. For example, man kiyanne meka other comprehensive income wala balapana palawikama item eka, right? For an example, an asset originally cost 5 million and was revalued to 15 million. Originally cost 5 million, now revalued to 15 million. Million pahak patin asset ekak pahe thibba asset ekak, right? Asset ekak tibuna 5 million, right? Thousands walin baluwoth balance, right? This was revalued to 15 million. The revaluation gain, right? 10 million revaluation got revaluation reserve. 10 million goes to revaluation reserve. The 10 million transfer to revaluation reserve is recognized in other comprehensive income and shown in the statement of profit and loss and other comprehensive income. Which means this asset, right? Then killed 20 million. Right? Then balance ekak thiyenawalu 20 million. Brought forward ena kiyadda? 20 million walata. Sorry, 15 million ne? 15 million. Right? එතකොට revaluation gain එක කීයද? Revaluation 10,000. Here asset account debit, credit to where? Other comprehensive credit, other comprehensive income. This is the only one transaction that you examine will be tested. Mehema thamai yanne revaluation gain eka. Credit to other comprehensive income. Simple. Statement of changes in equity. You can prepare in this way. The statement of profit and loss and other comprehensive income is straightforward measure of the financial performance of the entity. In that, it shows all items of income and expenses recognized in the period that we know, that we have discussed. It is then necessary to link these results with the results of transaction with owners of the business, such as share issue and dividends. The statement making the link is the statement of changes in equity. A statement amada karanna apita wadanne balanna format ekak. ABC company statement of changes in equity for the year ended 31st December 2000 whatever the year. So they have recognized entity and title of the statement and which period covers, everything is there, right? So what are the columns? Stated capital, revaluation surplus and retained earning and total. So you have a balance, right? Changes in accounting policy. I told you, changes in accounting policy, we will adjust retrospectively to retain earning. So then you have to adjust that to retain earning. Then restated balance you have, right? After correcting those balances, what is the revised balance? Then dividend you will deduct and you will add other comprehensive income, which is revaluation gain, right? And if there is any new share issue, that also you can add. Finally, you can take the balance and those balances you will transfer to what? Balance sheet. Those you will transfer to balance sheet. Dividend paid during the year are not shown on the statement of profit or loss. They are shown in the statement of changes in equity. Dividend paid, you will not take into statement of profit or loss. you will deduct it from what? Retained earning from when you prepare changes in equity statement. Done. So we have discussed all component of financial statement, right, including statement of comprehensive income or else statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income, and statement of financial position, and statement of changes in equity, and cash flow statement. Anyway, I am not going to discuss under this, because if you look at previous webinar series, we have prepared many cash flow statements. You go and watch those videos. And finally, we have discussed changes in equity statement. What are the elements, what are the transaction balances you will reflect there, how do you prepare it. And finally, we have to have hands-on experience of what? Preparation of financial statements. So those who are not good in preparation of company accounts, after comprehensive classes that we have participated when you complete your A-level exams, and those who have confusion still, this is good opportunity for you to understand the way you prepare company accounts. This is not a big question, but here the importance is examiner is testing what? MCQ. If when examiner asks comprehensive income, if you present profit for the year, if it is written based exam, written exam, examiner can see what you have done, what you are going to present, what you have tried to do. Few marks can be given. But here, it's a matter of selecting the correct answer. Therefore, whether you are a knowledgeable student or whether you have done a small mistake or big mistake, examiner can't evaluate. 0 marks. Therefore, sometimes sabhi mehema karana one. Profit ekak aapama, profit for the year aapama, comprehensive income okkoma adjust karala ekaparama dala dana. Ehema karanna ba. Profit for the කියන එක comprehensive income, other comprehensive income කියලා revaluation gain එක add කරපම තමයි total comprehensive income වෙන්නේ. දැන් total comprehensive income මොකද්ද කියලා examiner අහන්න පුළුවන්. MCQ question එකකින්. ඔයා profit for the year දුන්නොත් වැරදි. හැබැයි ඔක ගණන් හදලා පෙන්නන තැනක් නම් examiner පුළුවන් ආරයිට් මේ ළමයා gross profit එක අරගෙන තිනා ඔක්කොම අරගෙන හරියට හදලා තිනා. Only there's a small mistake. මේ comprehensive income ගද්දී පොඩි calculation එකක් තියෙනවා. ලකුණු ටිකක් දෙන්න පුළුවන්. But here MCQ ඒවනේ හරිම දේ හරි ෆෝමැට් එකට හරි මෙතඩොලොජි එකට හරියට ඉගෙන ගන්න ඕනේ. එහෙම ඉගෙන ගන්න එක ගණක් ඇති. So this question is more than enough to understand the correct way of preparing what? Profit and loss statement, other comprehensive income statement, balance sheet. Stay with me till end of this question. Then if there is any confusion that you have relating to preparation of company accounts, will be clarified, I believe. Right? Fine. Done. What is the question? USD, a limited liability company, has following trial balance as at 31st December 2009. They have given you cash balance, inventory at 1st January 2019, administrative expense, distribution expense they have given, non-current assets, building, plant and equipments, motor vehicles they have given, suspense account, yes, there's a suspense account also, good question, because trial balance is not tally, that's why they are given, they have included suspense account, difference they have transferred to suspense account. Suspense account, many suspense accounts we have discussed. Accumulated depreciation, built-in plant and equipment, motor vehicle they have given. Retained earning they have given to us. Trade receivable also they have given. Purchases they have given. Dividend payment they have given. Sales revenue they have given. And trade payables also they have given. Stated capital, 1 million ordinary share issue at each at rupees 1.5 each they have given. So those information they have given for us, right? What they are asking now? Some additional information also they have given to us. What are the additional information they have given? Statement, sorry, following additional information is relevant. Manoade, depreciation to be provided as following: building at 5% straight line, charge to administrative expense. Depreciation, building depreciation, you have to charge to building account. Plant and equipment 20% on reducing balance basis, charge to what? Cost of sales. Third one, motor vehicle at 25% on trade on reducing balance basis, charge to distribution cost. No final dividend is being proposed. There's no final dividend. Final dividend ekak nellu. Good. No final dividend. A customer has gone bankrupt owing 76,000. 76,000 vatina debtor kenek bankrupt vela. This debt is not expected to be recovered and adjustment should be made. This debt is not expected to be recovered. An adjustment should be made. Api expect karanne nam recover karaganna. Furthermore, an allowance for receivable amount rupees 5% is receivable is to be set up. Furthermore, an allowance for receivable amount into rupees 5% of recoverable receivable to be set up. 1 million new ordinary shares were issued, 1 million new ordinary shares were issued at rupees 1.5 on 1st December 2009. The proceeds have been left in suspend account. Suspend account ekata gihilla tiyenne metane. Closing inventory 1.6 million. Requirement: prepare the statement of profit or loss for the year end, for the year to 31st December 2019, a statement of changes in equity and statement of financial position at that date in accordance with the requirement of LKS SLFRS. Ignore taxation. They are asking you to prepare statement of profit for the year 31st December 2019 and statement of changes in equity, statement of financial financial position. Those are the statement they are asking you to prepare. So take down this question, right? Since it's a video, you can pause this video and see all the balances and additional information. I'm going to discuss this question with you, right, step by step. So those who are not good in preparation of financial statements for a company, this is a good opportunity for you to polish your knowledge, I would say. Right, done. Right, we need to prepare profit and loss statement, and we need to prepare balance sheet. Right, first we'll structure those two, so then it is easy for us to go through. Right, fine. Statement of profit and loss for the year ended 31st, they are asking that, no, they are asking you to prepare what? statement of profit or loss for the year to 31st December 2019. Statement of profit or loss for the year ended 31st March 2019. The company name also should be there, but this MCQ, but keep that in your mind. කොහොමද තියෙන්න ඕනේ කියලා. නම තියෙන්න ඕනේ, date එක තියෙන්න, period cover තියෙන්න ඕනේ, title එක තියෙන්න, currency එක තියෙන්න, all these things should be there, but I'm not going to that extent. This since this MCQ, but MCQ නත් ඒක අහන්න පුළුවන්. Remember. Right. Then they ask in statement of changes in equity, right? Changes in equity for the year ended 31st December 2019 and the financial position. Api mithanama space limitation is there, right? Statement of changes in equity for the year ended 31st March 2019, right? Done. Then we need statement of financial position as at 31st March 2019, right? Thereafter, yeah, those are the things we required, and we need notes, no? Notes. Workings. Workings. We'll start with notes. Wow, hundra madhyan me notes or indama game patangan noni. Palavini ka modi gan. The following additional information is relevant. Depreciation to be provided as follows. Depreciation. Hena apni gahali mu. Apni to oni namaka depreciation ka na katha kar the PP note tega ne. Property, plant and equipment note tega. Property, plant and equipment. Plant and equipment. Note. Work in one. Right? Make them a note take up. Work in one nigga. Trap you only a cost taker. Cost of the asset, let us accumulate a depreciation, accumulate depreciation kocharagda, depreciation for the year and the carrying amount which is there in the balance sheet finally. Monawath thiyena assets warga tika, we have building. Plant and equipment equipments motor vehicles. Before you calculate depreciation, go and check what is there in the trial balance. Meka thamai unknown krame. Depreciation ne methana fill karaganna kala api metheka daagena ona, which is there in the trial balance already. Non current assets thiyenama building 10,000 Then plant and equipment 1400. Motor vehicle 320. Api cost ekak daagatta. Then oya trial balance ekak tick karaganna, right? We have done these things. Then this is MCQ question. Ewa wae. Hondara oluwa thiyaganna. Kola kala gonna nan danna, right? Mewa consider. We have considered. It passe apita thiyenawa. After that, accumulated depreciation also they have given in the trial balance. They must be given, right? Otherwise, we don't know. No. 4,480 and 120. Correct, right? 4,000 building, plant and equipment 480. Vehicle 120. Done. Then we depreciation calculate karam. Kohomada calculate karanne kiyala kiyanne? Building at 5% straight line charge to administrative expense. 5% straight line. 5% straight line means kisi kathawak ne cost ekata 5% gahanna. 10,000 into 5%. 500. 500. Make a charge karnalu administrative expense or work in two admin expense. Admin expense will trial balance ke balance ek athi TBA ke. From TB, there's a balance should come, right? In addition to that, building depreciation. Depreciation. How much? 500. Then double entry giyada kiyala kalpana karanna metanin gihilla asset walata yanawa current asset current carrying amount ekak metanin gihilla pnl ekata yanna oni hari gihilla thinaka double entry oluwi hama welawema depattra giyada kiyala balanna oni metenda damma kiyanne pnl ekata yanawa ena pnl debit wenawa debit una asset ekak adu kara asset ekak credit una me meten adu wenne double entry pass kara api plant and equipment at 20% on reducing balance basis. Reducing balance. Reducing balance ke liye make make adu karannalu. Reducing balance. Itda sarasiya cost ek plant and equipment. Me vendo harasiya depreciate karla thi na. As of now, carry number how much? 1400 minus accumulated depreciation 480 equal to 920. Out of that, from that 20%. 184. Kohomada calculate karanne? Reducing balance method. I don't have space, therefore, let me work out here. 1400 minus 480 into 25%. Sorry, 20%. Equal 184. Equal 184. This is how do you calculate what? Depreciation of plant and equipment. Motor vehicle again reducing balance method. Sorry, that will be charged to cost of sales. Plant and equipment use karanne production nege ehinda eka depreciation charge karanne cost of sale. Work in two, work in three, cost of sale, right? Cost of sale, depreciation, what? Plant 184. Motor vehicle 25% on reducing balance basis charged to distribution cost. Same ni. Mama na I make liye inna reducing balance. 320 minus 120 into 25%. 50. It should charge to ya. Distribution cost, work in 4. Distribution cost, how much? They will give some balances from trial balance. Here, depreciation, motor vehicle. Because motor vehicle will use for what purpose? to distribute goods, 50. Right? No final dividend means proposed. All right. Then kathandare ivarai ne. Right. Property plant and equipment ivarai. Ohoma tiyanna. Bawenna ba. Mema tiyela api yang notes ti ivara karanna. Kalabara wenna. My advice is don't go and finalize this first because we don't know. Some adjustments will come with some other notes, relating to some other notes. If you are comfortable, you can finish this and go to next note, but stay with this. No final dividend is proposed. Final dividend agnellu. Okay. Netta prashnam ne. The customer has bankrupt. A customer has gone bankrupt. Customer kinek bankrupt velalu. Right? Customer kinek bankrupt vela. Yeah, 76,000, the total debit is not expected to be recovered and adjustment should be made. Furthermore, all allowance for receivable amounting to 5% is to be set up. What has happened? Customer has gone bankrupt. Customer is bankrupt. Right? Impairment. Admin expense. Impairment. Debtor. Impairment. Debtor. Kiya the 76,000. Methaning PNL at 76,000. PNL debit to nama credit in the balance sheet. Teka. Aava api balance sheet teka. Non-current assets. You have a current asset. Equity. You have and non-current liabilities you have, current liabilities you have. Asset take me hari tally bin no. Current asset to number one, debtor. Balance ka kiya tha? Abhi debtor ibar kar lene dhe. Kamu balance, trial balance ka debtors wala. Debtors la inna trade receivable 876. 876 balance in the trial balance, from that you deduct 76. Okay, impairment ekak thiyena. Eth ekkama kiyenawa impairment is that much. This debt is not expected to be recovered and adjustment should be made. Furthermore, an allowance for receivable amount at 5% is to be set up. Allowance for receivable. Receivable allowance at the end of 5%. Receivable allowance. Eka charge in a PNL. Allowance for receivable. Then we balanno ni giya urudde. Netta meet a kalim webinar series seke allowance for receivable. There was a comprehensive topic. Go and watch that video. Right? Balance taking up at the end of 5% allowance. 876 city debtors. Aduna 76, 800, ekada 5% gahapuhama 40. Debtors line aduinawa, PNL at 40 anawa. Wede hari. Ilanga note ekak. 1 million new share was issued at 1.5 on 1st December 2009. The suspense account have been left. Sorry, the proceed have been left in the suspense account. Minna meekulu suspense account ekak thiyenne. Mokada suspense account ekak thiyenne? Credit balance ekak. Suspense account. Suspense account ekak balance ekak thiyenawa 15,000. Right? Sorry, 1,500. 1,500 balance ekak thiyenawa. Make a mokha the venno again. A 1 million new ordinal shares have been new shares were issued at ₹1.5 on December 2009. The proceeds have been left in the suspense account. Suspense account again debit karan. New share issue. New share. 1500 1 million in 1.5 මෙතන debit උනා credit උනා කොහෙද equity statement එකට ආ equity statement එක මොනවද තියෙන headers දැන් අපිට එනවා share capital එක share capital ඇති retained earning revaluation මොකුත් නැහැ total right මේ Samvya here you have new share issue मैंने क्रेडिट ना शेयर कैपिटल लेकर किया था 1500 टोटल 1500 में तेरे ना क्रेडिट में तेरे ना बैलेंस शीट टेक रहे हैं नहीं राइट सस्पेंस अकाउंट का भी क्लियर करा एंट्री अन्य दे मैंने सस्पेंस अकाउंट डेबिट शेयर कैपिटल क्रेडिट में तेरे ने कुछ करा राइट डन क्लोजिंग इन्वेंट्री 1.6 मिलियन आ क्लोजिंग इन्वेंट्री अपने ओनली में ने कॉस्ट ऑफ सेल कैलकुलेशन नहीं कॉस्ट ऑफ सेल हाउ डू यू कैलकुलेट opening inventory opening balance inventory should be there purchase and closing balance inventory how much 1.6 1600 closing inventory metana credit una metana adu wenawa pnl credit une ne cost of sale adu ne wenne හැම එන්ට්‍රි එකම හැම දාන එකකම ඩබල් දෙක දෙපැත්තක් ලියවෙන්න ඕනේ. එක අංකයක් මම කොහරි ලිව්වොත් ඒ අංකය අනිත් පැත්තේ ලියවෙන්න ඕනේ මේ 76 40 76 40 184 185 හැම තැනම තියෙනවා කොහරි දැනක. දෙපාරක් ලියවෙන්න ඕනේ. එහෙනම් මෙතන P&L එක ක්‍රෙඩිට් උනා ඩෙබිට් උනා ඉන්වෙන්ටරි බැලන්ස් ෂීට්. How much? 1600. මෙතන ඩෙබිට් P&L ක්‍රෙඩිට්. That's why I wrote it as minus figure. ඔක්කොම ඉවරයි adjustments simple question that's I told you right from the beginning we can go now cash 100 මොකද adjustment නැහැ කෙලින්ම දාන්න balance sheet එකේ current asset cash 100 දැම්මා inventory 2200 inventory 2200 opening balance 2200 trial balance එකේ තියෙනව අරගෙන උන කිසිම double entry එකක් නැහැ වයි straight forward double entry දාලා තියෙන්නේ adjustments වලට තමයි double entry වෙටෙන්නේ මේක දැන් 2020 double entry එකක් නැහැ කිලිම මෙතෙන් ගත්තා මෙතන යනවා cost of sale වලට distribution expenses sorry admin expenses 2206 admin expenses 200 2006 sorry 2206 admin expenses distribution cost 650 distribution cost trial balancing you know 650 And build in apikatta suspense account we have considered done accumulated depreciation also we got retained earning opening balance retained and opening balance 876 right 876 purchases sorry trade receivable apikatta 876 purchases also we have not not considered 4200 double entry එකක් යන්නේ කියලා මොකද purchase වලින් එන්නේ trial balance එකෙන් එන්නේ dividend paid 200 dividend paid we have discussed we will not deduct it from pnl but we will consider it for what changes in equity dividend you will pay from retained earning 200 minus 200 you will pay from there dividend sales revenue sales there's no adjustment straight away sales you can include in the face of the income statement sales 13142 right and trade payable 1050 no adjustment current liabilities creditor 1050 straight away you can put here then share capital we have considered right share capital 1500 is their share capital this is not that new share issue don't be confused this opening balance this straight away they are 1 million shares issued at 1.5 so this is not this new share issue because new share issue where they have mentioned they have included in suspense account from that we brought to this is opening balance 1500 plus 876 2376 opening balance of equity here 360, right? Sorry, retained earning. Retained earning 360. Sorry. Let me change. That's why you have to be careful when you pick numbers. If you take wrong numbers, answer will be wrong. 360. 1860. We have done. Now it's a matter of completing these things, right? Work in one complete column. 10,000 minus 4,000 minus 500. 5,500. Then 1,400 plant and equipment minus 480 minus 184. 736. 320 minus 120 minus 50. 150. Total plus 3736 plus 5500. 6386. So non-current assets, building, plant and equipment, motor vehicle. 5,500, 736, 150. Altogether 6386. Done. Work in 1, we have completed. Administrative expense, work in 2. How much? 2206 plus 500 plus 76 plus 40. 2822. Admin expense. Expense 2822. 2,822. Cost of sale we can finalize now. Opening balance inventory 2,200 plus 4,200 minus 1,600, 4,800 plus depreciation 184, 4,984. Cost of sales 4,984. Then gross profit 13,142, 8,158, right? Then distribution cost 700, distribution expense, these are simple, admin you have to minus 700. This is done, this is done, work in 4 also done, suspense account also done, everything done. Now it's a matter of calculating profit now, net profit or profit for the year. We don't have other comprehensive income items, therefore we can end up with this. Plus 2822 plus 700. Total profit 4,636. This is the total profit figure. You will bring this to equity and equity statement profit. You will add that to retained earning 4,636. 4,636. Now you can take the sum of changes in equity also. 1,500, 3,000. Here 360 minus 200 plus 4,636, 4,796, 1,860 minus plus 1,500 plus 4,636 minus 200 dividend, 7,796 total equity balance. Total equity balance 7,796 equity balance. P&L we have done, changes in equity statement we have calculated, profit for the profit from this you have transferred to this, changes in equity. LKS 1, then balance sheet. balance sheet විතරයි අපිට ඉතුරු වෙලා තියෙන්නේ. Creditors ලා දාගත්තා ඔක්කොම හරි 1700 නේ. Sorry, here debtors we have to calculate. 876 minus 76 minus 40. 760 plus 1600 plus 100. 2460 current assets, right? 2460 plus 6386, 8846. Balance sheet 7796 plus 1050, 8846 balance sheet tally. So this is also done. So these are steps when you prepare financial statements. So if you follow each and every step, right, finally you can complete first income statement, which means profit and loss and other comprehensive. Here other comprehensive part is not there. If it is if revaluation gain or loss there, you have to consider that also, but in this question that was not there. Then you complete changes in equity statement, then take those balances to balance sheet and complete balance sheet. So if you follow these steps, it's not a big deal to prepare financial statement. Examiner will not test everything, I believe, because the MCQ question within 2 or 3 minutes you can't do this. But let's say if examiner given this number and given some adjustment for revaluation reserve, then asking what total amount you should transfer to other changes in equity can be tested. So examiner will give total asset side and figure out maybe current liabilities by applying formulas, balance sheet formulas. Those kind of questions can be tested, but this understanding is important to next level as well as, yes, as well as when you manage MCQ question, strategic MCQ question. Sometimes examiner will ask you to calculate only what the cost of sales, only sometimes administrative expenses, only sometimes not PP not, right, kind of thing, right, fine. So during the session what we have gone through from the beginning, preparation of financial statement, LKS 1, formats we have discussed, each and every component of financial statement in detail we have discussed, and one comprehensive question we have discussed to cover profit and loss statement, changes in equity and statement of financial position. With this, I believe any MCQ question from preparation of financial statement for a limited liability company, you can manage. Preparation of financial statement for a proprietary company, you can watch in previous webinar series. Combine those two videos and go through it again. So then any question from preparation of financial statement, whether it's from proprietor or from partnership or company account, will not be a challenging task for you all. Thank you.